Welcome, ghosts and ghouls. I've been meaning to touch up on this for a while. Oh, that's not right. I apparently didn't prepare this scene very well. Let's get a chroma key on there. There we go. So yeah, it has been a bit since I've streamed. I had a fairly busy week, so to be able to play on stream again is nice. I kind of did like a stream on Thursday, but that was sort of a chance occurrence more than anything else. However, at the moment, I have Devil May Cry readied up for my third game in rotation. I'm currently kind of doing like a rotation thing for my games, rather than having like set days like the other VCATs. So for me, I don't have like set days for any of my games. I go from one game, and then after that stream, I go to the next game in the rotation, and it just keeps looping from there. Kinda messy, but hey, what can you do? So for now, we've got Devil May Cry. Of course, we're gonna start on normal mode.
Two millenniums ago, there was a war.
What in the world?
The human world and the other, the underworld. But some.
Oh, there we go.
Somebody from the underworld woke up to justice and stood up against this legion alone. His name was Sparta. Later, he quietly reigned the human world. Continued to preserve harmony until his death. He became a legend. The legendary Dark Knight, Sparta.
This FMV is really compressed.
Cry. I'm sorry, we closed at 9. Again, no password. I can't seem to get any real business.
Whoa, slow down, babe.
Well, well, what do we have here? Nature calls? It's in the back.
So, you must be the handyman who'll take any dirty job. Am I correct?
Almost. I only take special jobs, if you know what I mean.
You're the man who lost a mother and a brother to evil 20 years ago. The son of the legendary Dark Knight Sparta, Mr. Dante.
Well, the way I figure it, in this business, a lot of your kind comes around. And if I kill each one that comes, eventually I should hit the jackpot sooner or later.
In that case, you should be used to this sort of thing.
Time to go to work, guys. Even as a child, I had powers. There's demonic blood in me.
What strength?
You were the first one to know about my inventions. It looks like I'm getting closer.
It seems that way, but I'm not your enemy. My name is Trish. I came here to seek your help, to put an end to the underworld.
What?
Were sealed by Sparta. He's attempting to gain control of the human world once again. He has been preparing to open the gate on Malay Island. The castle is above this cliff. Come on, let's go!
Alright, and now we're here in normal gameplay. Now I gotta get reused to the controls. Yeah, this is definitely an old Capcom game. Now, let's see, I don't know a whole lot about this, but I know, like, bits and pieces. If I remember correctly, there's something you can get. Yeah. Because the general goal for, like, the first mission alone is basically just open a door, which I think requires the red orbs. Oh, wow, this is a lot faster than I remember the jump. Oh well. I don't even know if I'm supposed to jump over there. I seem to remember getting stuck on this bit. Oh. That was enough. I don't even need to collect all the red orbs then. Ain't that nice? Oh, there's a blue orb back there, actually. And I know for a fact that I am going to get slapped a lot in this game. Yeah, my knowledge of Devil May Cry is admittedly quite limited. I used to know how to get up there easily. Well, that seems to be a way. There we go. And with that, a blue orb fragment. How many do I need? 4 of them. 2 out of 4 isn't bad. But yeah, the camera angles are going to be the weirdest part for me. Because it controls like a normal 3D game, but the camera angles are still in like classic Resident Evil style. Which, if you didn't know, Devil May Cry originally started out as Resident Evil 4. But because it was so different from previous entries in the series, they changed it to be its own thing. Kind of weird to think about, really. Just think, this is what Resident Evil 4 could have been. Elements of that still show. Those who desire to acquire the ancient ways of war shall offer the blood of monsters in exchange. Oh yeah, this is why you want the blue orbs and stuff, because it gives you like special abilities for your weapons, making you stronger. Well, maybe not stronger so much as you have the ability to do more stuff in battle. Because your moveset in the very beginning, if I remember, is fairly limited. It's been a while since I've played this, so chances are a lot of information that's in my head is either inaccurate or spotty. Which I guess isn't exactly uncommon for me at this point. Because that was how it was for Castlevania Curse of Darkness as well. Alright, got the rusty key. And this totally not going to come alive puppet, stay there. Who would have guessed? I don't remember how to play. Well, I didn't take damage, so there's that. To remember there being things here. Oh yeah, it's things that I can't access. You know, the classic. I believe in areas that I've been in, now there's going to be those dolls. Or not. Suits me. Oh, this area, there's a ton of them, though. And you can get into here. And there'll be, like, I think, sort of like an arena fight against a bunch of them. Trying to dodge like it's a Castlevania Curse of Darkness. That doesn't work in this game. bosses in this game. Let's see what I can manage, I guess. And the combo timer is quite strict, isn't it? Well, that cleared that. The grabby hand is now gone. And that puts us at 3. One more and I'll have an increase in life. I don't think there's anything here. Yeah. All right. Oh, I cleared the mission. For some reason, I thought that would be longer. Well, what ranking did I get? A B! Also, I just realized that the window capture is slightly cut off. And it's because I'm still using the crop for... I really did come in unprepared, didn't I? I want to say about 210? No? 20. Very strange stuff. Well, it doesn't seem to be cut off anymore. Very weird. Yeah, you can see that I have played a little bit. Not very far, but did not already. Oh. I see, it's doing that thing. Alright, second mission. I don't have anything to power up yet. When I get, like, more abilities, the combo timer should be more forgiving. I believe most of the abilities you can get in this game are also stuff related to, like, delaying your attacks slightly. Yeah, there's like a delay you need to do. Why is the music still going on? Is someone still alive? here. Oh, there he is. He's pretty low on health. There's a sculpture of a female in agony with a sword pierced through her chest. Wait, I can hear a voice. I am Alistair. The weak shall give their heart and swear their eternal loyalty to me. Oh yeah, this scene. Hilt and all. I think this is the first weapon that you can actually upgrade to. Yeah, I don't remember what Alistair's special moves are. I believe they're, for the most part, pretty basic until you unlock stuff. Oh, one thing I do remember. Here's the shotgun. It might be good. Take the key. And then, next up, bad things will happen. Because anytime you take anything in this game, bad things. I don't remember how much the abilities cost to get, but we'll see. Oh, there's another fight here. I have a gun too. don't think the gun does anything for the combo. Judge the distance so bad there. There's an immense power that will not allow anyone to get closer. Before I can confront the lion, I'll need a sign. Alright, so I gotta collect a thing, basically. There's a lot of key hunting that I remember. Can't believe I dodged that. This is where the guiding souls gather. I need to get a thing for that, I guess. There's something written here. A god stands before thee to open the path, use thy strength to drive it back. Oh, here's that one area. Staff of Judgment. Ah, these things. These are like wraiths with like giant shears. They have a lot of defensive capabilities from what I remember. Alright, so there's three of them. Drop their shears and it hurts. Noted. I think there's like another fight with them somewhere. It's a painting of a middle-aged man. Well, that's all there is to it, apparently. Let's see, Staff of Judgment, if I recall, is to open like this. Only those who the lion has accepted can set me free. No, okay, so I'm looking in the wrong spot. Yeah. didn't fire soon enough. Ranged attacks are my weakness right now. Carving of the Judge of Death. It looks like the judge should be holding something. Shall I use the Staff of Judgment? Yes. And there we go. Mission clear. C rank. It's a pretty harsh rating system, isn't it? Also, let me just disable this crop entirely. There we go. Right. Save. I believe I actually am able to buy some power-ups. Okay, a power up. And then everything else. If I recall, you don't want to actually spend a whole lot of money on anything other than, like, your ability power ups. Well, I believe we're getting close to the first boss fight. Which is also, you know, the first major point to destroy me. The pride of the lion is granted only to those who can choose the path of trials. Gyrating cement trees. If I recall, a bridge breaks beneath you. Like, you interact with this and it's like, oh, by the way, the bridge broke. Oh, hello, Phantasmagoric Cat. How are you? It states, go back the path, and thou shalt return from the abyss with thy lion heart, and thou shalt receive the pride of lion. Okay. And now the bridge breaks. Soon. Right? Yay. I kind of remember things. Dude, again, mostly gonna lurk because Sunday chores, but happy to see some crying devils. Feel free to lurk. It can be like that. Mostly for me, Sunday has nothing super special about it. Which is, you know, nice. Alright, the pride of the lion. We now have it. Time for a boss fight. Get on top of him. I don't remember. This guy hits hard, too. Ow! Well, first death. Gives you, like, a certain amount of lives to do this, and... It kind... Like, I'm gonna be honest, this is like a... difficulty spike, almost. Compared to everything else that you fight prior to this. I don't mind it, it's just... Oof! Help. Accidentally triggered my devil trigger. Well, that worked, I guess. First boss fight down. And it's a tough one, at least for me. Some people might have, like, no issue with it. I'm sure there's people who have done, like, countless damageless runs of that particular fight. But I'm not good at hack and slashes. C rank. So that puts me on mission 4 now, I believe. Let's see, can I acquire anything? Air raid. The one thing that Devil May Cry 1 doesn't really do is tell you how to use your abilities. So you just sort of hope for the best. So here I have air raid. I don't know if it's any good. Unless they've got, like, something on here? Oh. Press RB while jumping in Devil Trigger state. Press B or X to strike execution. Okay. Come over here, you bug, now. Oh. I know you can beat him in that, but I don't know how. I guess I'll just do the normal thing and run. Oh, the stun. How? He hits really hard. At the very least, I can recover some health like this. Because I did take quite a beating. Oh, I missed the green orb. Timed out. Yeah, it was this. And then I get to fight yet another boss fight. Magical destruction will awaken him. So you break that. This little shadow wolf comes in and... Oh yeah, I forgot about that entirely. Yeah, this game doesn't really hold your hand on anything. It will beat you down. I'll probably run out of lives, honestly. Deflects damage. And game over. I didn't know that there was game over scenes of any sort. Seems a little unnecessary, but well, whatever. I think I understand now. Pardon, what? What? How did it go down so quickly? I think I did something a little unusual. Such as, you know, not completely sucking. Yeah, I have no more yellow orbs, so if I die, it's game over now. There's something written. Oh, I skipped that. The sword is the key to freeing the soul. The key resides at the highest place. Oh yeah, you need to get a certain sword to do that. And then there's an upgrade station right here. With me being unable to buy anything. Well, damn. Sealed shut with immense power. There's something. This path will open with a guiding soul. There's something here. Oh, yeah. So I need to do this thing again. And that will raise this platform. And let me reach the highest point. Now I have the sword. So now I can stab the statue, and the statue will let me get stabbed by another man.
stinking hole was the last place I thought I'd find anyone with some guts.
So now I have to beat up that dude. Gonna be an experience, tell you what. Here comes the game over. I know that this guy gives me more trouble than any of the other bosses, which is saying something, because I've died a lot already. That didn't take long. You can start again from a save point. Yes, go to load point. Forget, did I buy something? Yeah, I bought Air Raid before the mission started. I'm gonna try and save up for Stinger level 2, or maybe round trip. Air hike can be really good as well, I imagine. Double jumping is always nice. More moves would just simply be nicer. Air raid feels a little situational at the moment. I accidentally found out how to dodge. Out of that camera. I wonder if they ever actually improved the cameras in, like, the old PS2 series. I imagine they did with 4 and 5, but I really cannot say for sure if they did in... There we go. No damage. That's more like it. While I don't mind not having to control the camera, I would honestly appreciate it in this game. I got a stylish rating.
Thank you.
Alright. I'm curious if the newer, like the games after this one, if they kept that mission structure. I'm gonna save up for round trip for next one. You know, assuming I don't get completely decimated. Which is entirely possible, especially if I end up going the exact wrong direction of where I need to be. Which I'm pretty sure I have just done. Let it be known that I am very easy to... It's very easy for me to get lost. This is just the upgrade room. Okay. Oh, hello. Remember where to be going. Was it right through this door? I think it might have been. Yeah, it was. Now I gotta deal with this thing again. Hey, I did it. Without taking damage somehow. And I got an achievement. Almost have enough for that move. wonder if there's any way I can just skip the whole having to drop down thing and then just... Yeah. Yeah, there is. And it's fairly easy to pull off. Just shy. Now he's up there. Ouch. Let me use that vital star. There we go. Mission clear. Yeah, that's a... That was messy. Yeah, D rank. Had that been what I had performed, like, the first time, it probably would have given me a higher rank. And with that, I have enough to get round trip. So now I have to go up there. See it. Well, I cleared the mission pretty quick. Smashing Sensation? What's that achievement about? Oh! That's my first S rank! Shoot! I guess it's a good thing I remembered where that needed to be. See, can I get anything extra? No. There we go. Sorry, I just needed to check something real quick. So, that puts us on mission 6. We didn't have too many troubles going through this. What? I mean, I got a health increase. I'm perfectly fine with that. I just thought it was a doorway. Turns out, it was a fragment. I see what's going on here. Yep. Here's some bugs. And a lot of them. Luckily, I have a shotgun. I'm a professional exterminator. You don't need bug spray, you just need a fucking shotgun. Well, there goes my one, F-bomb for the PG-13 rating, eh? Is there another bug? Where is he? Oh. Ow. Hello. Let me stab you. had a decent amount of red orbs in them. And there goes the rusty key. Now, if I recall, there's a boss fight here that's, like, in a really cramped arena. Like, an obnoxiously cramped arena. But after this segment, everything is pretty much blind for me. Up here it is. The last thing I really remember. Well, I don't know if he's really a boss fight. I wish I had that vital star still. Yeah. Ugh. It's not easy to keep track of him, because he goes through walls like that. Yeah, and since I used my vital star, I don't got that anymore. What's with these? The part that looks like a cow's bone is their main body. Their evil is much stronger and tougher compared to the sins. They use many staves made from bones of animals and humans to create an evil barrier. This barrier is impenetrable, and you must defeat the enemy within it. Their screw attacks are accurate and very destructive. Dodge to escape these attacks. It's unwise to fight these evil spirits from the surface. Become a devil hunter and take the fight into the air. Weakest points. Huh. I mean, that makes it sound like it's more in depth than it really is, but. These respawn? No, they don't. Okay. So yeah, basically, I remember this fight mostly because it's kind of annoying. Primarily because of that screw attack that is just not an easy read. Yeah. obnoxious. Not gonna lie. At least that's the end of the mission. See, that puts us at mission 7. Stinger level 2. I'm gonna guess that, like, that giant lava spider's gonna come crashing in again. Yep. Luckily, you can avoid that one a little easier. Unless he comes crashing in again. What is going on? I just got here. What? Wasn't the whole thing to kill both of them? Coming from. Oh, I have to kill them. Okay. Ow. Stab. Now I really gotta rush between this secret mission and that, and the camera angles. The camera angles are not helping. The brightness of the guiding light will scorch you. Only those who bear the light can open the new path. Ouch. That is a lot of my life. Hopefully that's the end of the mission. C rank about what I've been getting. mostly because I think I can do a better one. I'll make another save. This is gonna be another boss fight, I think. It seems very boss fighty. Yeah, they're getting me ready for something. They wouldn't give me two chances to power up like that. Big boy again.
Finally, I was getting tired of playing your childish games.
That's new. There we go. Just barely survived it. Well,
defeated the Phantom. Incredible power.
What you didn't see is all the times I died horribly. No. Let me in. There we go. A skeleton. I now have the grenade launcher. I don't remember anything about that. But there we go. I have a grenade launcher. Something. Understanding what the game's trying to convey is all. At least I have a little bit of health. Should have been an easy clear, but I didn't understand what it wanted me to do. All right. I'm gonna save up for air hike. Guess you can't return there. There's a little upgrade station if you needed it, I guess? But I don't know why you would, since, like, you just loaded out of a mission. Wonder if the mission things were added later in development, and that's why some of those upgrade stations are in those spots. Armored lizards. Not the cleanest kills. But hey, a yellow stone. It gives me an extra life. There's an emblem of a shield on the door that glows with red light. And there's one that glows with blue light. Oop, didn't do that. Another yellow orb. Given my tendency to die, that's a very useful thing to have. That looks like what I'm supposed to be doing. So instead, let's ignore it for now. Well, now I can restore my devil trigger. A platforming thing with these controls, really? Ah, oh, boy. Damn it! I was hoping I could cheese it. Okay, platforming segment with really, really bad platforming controls. Got it. And again, Ninja Gaiden on the Xbox didn't exactly have very good platforming controls either, from what I remember. Well, I did it. There's an inscription on the base. My name is Ifrit. The fool who awakens me shall pay dearly with the fires of hell. Okay. Oh, new weapons, essentially. Camera, please. Less abrupt camera changes in a combat arena are nice. But that is a giant thing. A lot of bullets. go out on a limb and say that the grenade launcher may do more damage for when he's flying. It does, indeed. Mistimed. Ouch. I didn't even get a hurt sound, I just fell on the ground. Yeah, I don't know if the fists are the best weapon for this. Yeah, bad timing. At least it's kind of forgiving with that being... Oh, okay. Topmost you can't jump on. Thank you. He's not a very angry thing. I'm not very good at platforming. Did I get anything from that, maybe? Shields that glow with light and a pair of lances shall lead to the battleground. Okay, so that's not my thing yet. So maybe here? Words are carved here. A pair of flames that dwell with strength will open the path. So it wants me to equip Ifrit, right? Oh, wrong button. Okay, maybe not. Sealed shut from the other side. Holy water holds the power to eliminate all evil around. So if I ever end up having a situation where there's too many enemies and I'm having a bad time, I can just use the holy water, I guess. I doubt it's anything over here. Honestly, I expected it to end as soon as I finished up that boss. Or the mission to end, at least. No, it kept going. Charge power and release it in the form of a magma uppercut. A quick but powerful flaming back roundhouse kick. Its impact will drive the enemy back. Rolling blaze, surround the body in flame and damage enemies upon contact immediately. Those should be good. Hmm. That big one was painful. Escalated in difficulty for this game. Back here. There we go. Still confused about this. So I could have avoided that entire fight if I had paid attention to the fact that these are flaming gloves. Ooh, moody. What's going on here? Definitely better with the sword. Luckily, I am familiar with these enemies, and they're not very threatening. Except for when, like, that auto-target thing doesn't quite do what you want it to. Have a good night, Mew. I have been very rusty at this game. I have died a lot. Let's see. I'm gonna save money so I can get Air Hike. Or maybe Rolling Blaze. I don't know which one yet. Ouch. Suddenly block and breathe fire on you. Especially with the delay after being deflected. Like, what am I actually supposed to do with that? I guess I'm supposed to jump, but, like, sometimes it just doesn't fully do that. Is there, like, an input buffer? Because that might be what's going on, actually, because I do get a little mashy with my buttons. That one was actually sure. Because I don't know when they do that deflect move. Was I just gonna keep going until I had enough red orbs to open that or something? Sometimes this game's mission structure is very strange. Yeah, D rank. So let's see, that will have put me at 2 hours for the day. So, as I've explained before, I'm planning on doing sort of a game rotation sort of deal. So next stream, which should be tomorrow, that should be Shining Force. And then after that should be Castlevania Curse of Darkness. And then it will be back to Devil May Cry, and it'll keep doing that loop until I complete one of those games, in which case that one game in the rotation will be replaced with something else. I'm thinking, honestly, that when it comes to, Shining Force, once that's completed, I'm going to do Skies of Arcadia. And once Castlevania Curse of Darkness is completed, I don't know yet. I'm still figuring that one out. But for the time being, it is definitely the end of the stream. My tracking's a little funky at the moment, don't worry about that. But, yeah. Everyone who stopped by, whether they were lurking or otherwise, have a nice day. I'm gonna try streaming more regularly now that I've got a decent idea of how my work schedule is gonna look like. a lot of 8-to-4s. But yeah. All of you take care. I'm going back to my grave.